Good afternoon. There are fears the AACTA Awards may become a super spreader event after a worker tested positive. Charles Crouch joins us now live with the details from Sydney. Charles, many of Australia's biggest celebrities are now being forced to isolate.
They were there on the red carpet, Dougal, and now that is a potential exposure site, the AACTA Awards. It was a back-of-house staff worker there that was working in the catering team. Now, so far, this isn't being listed as a close contact or casual contact site, so people will be getting tested and then resuming with those negative results. In particular, the audience all had masks on while inside and had all been double-vaxxed, so we wait to see what happens there. This, though, is just the latest of a number of new exposure sites in New South Wales, involving pubs, clubs, parties, all the things associated with the silly season. A hotel in Parramatta is now a close contact site, people isolating for 7 days. And all this comes as we're now around 32 hours away from Queensland opening its border to the rest of New South Wales and Victoria. That all happens in the early hours of Monday morning. And right now there's a collection of people that are holding out, camping out in Byron Bay up to Tweed Heads, effectively treading water, marking time until Monday morning. Here is one of those people.
I'm camped here for 3 nights to wait for the Anna to let me through the border.
560 new cases here in New South Wales today, Dougal. That's the largest daily caseload in more than 2 months.
OK, Charles Croucher, thank you. COVID testing numbers across the country are surging, with a near record number of Victorians turning out to get swabbed in the past 24 hours. Emily Rice reports.
Just 2 weeks until Christmas and Melbourne is bustling in the shopping precincts and across our COVID testing clinics.
A near record number of Victorians, 82,895, were swabbed in the past 24 hours.
That is more than triple the number of people turning out for a test during the lockdown in August.
Demand has increased quite dramatically. What we're finding is people are stepping on mines wherever they go.
While COVID rates are not exploding, Victoria's daily caseload remains the highest in the nation, with 1,193 new coronavirus infections, 323 people in hospital and 13 deaths.
We've had to furlough 12 staff last week and also 6 staff this week. And that's not because of any infection they picked up here, but because of infections in the community.
The Department of Health says testing capacity has almost doubled in the past 2 months, with 250 sites now open. These include several drive-throughs, which are open from 7 a.m. till 7 p.m. We know the morning is the busiest time for testing, which is why we're now opening some sites earlier to cater for the morning peak. While testing rates are high, COVID panic is low here in Victoria, in contrast to the mood interstate. South Australia appears to be suffering a little pandemic panic. It's announced a new Omicron-related rule. Now, even fully vaccinated people will have to quarantine for 14 days if they are deemed a close contact of an Omicron infection.
It's probably got a shorter incubation period, if anything, compared with Delta. So asking people to stay in quarantine for 14 days might be longer than you actually need.
Queensland too, a little jittery after recording one new COVID case.
From Monday, we are going to have thousands and thousands of people flocking from hotspots into Queensland. Yes, they're fully vaccinated, but they can bring the virus still.
In Victoria, we seem to be going about our Christmas business in a COVID-safe and calm manner.
Treasurer Josh Frydenberg has warned state and territory leaders to keep calm and to continue to open borders despite growing cases of the new Omicron variant. Rachel Baxter has the details.
Treasurer Josh Frydenberg says Omicron won't derail the nation's economic recovery. Revealing today, ahead of next week's budget update, business investment is up 16% compared to last year. It comes as Queensland, Tasmania and the Northern Territory prepare to open their borders next week. That's despite growing cases of the new variant. The challenge now will be how Australia learns to live with the virus. The Treasurer warning state and territory leaders to keep borders open and stick to the national plan.
States need to keep calm and carry on and not overreact to the Omicron variant.
The government is under pressure over its outlook for jobs and wages, though. Labor says salaries are stagnating.
The government's own budget had real wages going backwards. Many Australians are feeling the pinch. getting that sense that there's more month than money.
What is certain, economic recovery is shaping up to be a major issue for both sides of politics as voters prepare to head to the polls, with an election due by May at the latest.
Fugitive conman Peter Foster has arrived back in Queensland, where he'll spend the weekend behind bars before facing court on Monday. Natasha Kramer has the details.
For 6 months, Queensland police have been trying to locate serial conman Peter Foster. Today, he was back under their watch. Marched off a flight at Brisbane Airport this afternoon in handcuffs and surrounded by officers, having been extradited from Melbourne. The wanted fugitive was located on Tuesday in Victoria's Macedon Ranges following 6 months on the run. A warrant was issued for the 59-year-old's arrest when he failed to attend a court hearing in Sydney earlier this year. It's alleged Foster conned close to $2 million worth of Bitcoin out of a Hong Kong pilot between 2019 and 2020. Charges were dropped in New South Wales. Queensland police are yet to lay any.
We'll be fighting charges.
Oh yeah, this is nonsense. This is bogus. I'm not worried about this at all.
The notorious fraudster will spend the weekend behind bars here at the Brisbane Watch House before he fronts court on Monday.
The man accused of running down a Queensland police officer is tonight behind bars, ending a three-day manhunt spanning Brisbane to the Gold Coast. 19-year-old Jamal Payton's run from the law ended after he was found on the roof of a house around 8 p.m. last night. Payton is facing serious criminal charges, including attempted murder. His co-accused remains on the run, has been urged to hand himself in. Victoria Police is hunting a missing sex offender after he failed to report to authorities. 48-year-old Marvin Morgan was living in Melbourne's inner southeast and has been actively avoiding police.
Police have information that Marvin Morgan may be frequenting the St Kilda and South Melbourne areas, however, have been unable to locate him to date.
Marvin Morgan is approximately 160 centimetres tall with a medium build and short dark hair. A curious canine has been rescued after falling down a mineshaft. Terry the Kelpie Cross got into trouble after wandering from his owner in Victoria's Wombat State Forest. Specialist crews helped with the delicate rescue, which took around 3 hours.
Lots of pats indeed. Terry jumped straight into his owner's arms and then into the warm car afterwards. So, yes, very happy dog.
Thankfully, the pup was unharmed and, while a little shaken, was in good spirits. Ahead in the news, tributes for the Monkees star Michael Nesmith, who's died aged 78. Cruel vandals deface graves at a suburban memorial park, and the surprise song Ruffling Feathers on the ARIA charts.